Hey, it's Ellie. Welcome back to another episode of the Elder Scrolls V
Before I
Skyrim.
let you interrupt them,
In the last
I have
episode,
questions.
we got a house, and in this episode, we are going to get a family. We're going to get married and
How
adopt
does it
some
matter?
children. So we're here in Riften trying to get that quest so we can get the Amulet of Mara and unlock marriage. The Scarred seems to be trying to,
Keep your voice down. You want everyone to hear you.
Rob us.
Let you in. Just let me unlock the gate.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
The gate's
Don't
unlocked.
Make me shoot you.
Head inside when you're ready. Take my advice.
I'm not taking any advice from that guy. He just tried to rob me. What the heck? There's a lot going on here.
You and Riften looking for trouble?
Everyone's just trying to freaking make a fight with me.
Don't say something you'll regret. Last thing the Blackbriars need is some loudmouth trying to meddle in their affairs.
Oh, all right then. I don't even
the Blackbriars
know
have
who they are.
And the Thieves Guild watching their back, so keep your nose out of their business. Me? I'm Maul. I watch the streets for him. If you need dirt on anything, I'm your guy. But it'll cost you.
All right, then.
Yeah, walk away like a good dog. Stay out of the
Wow! People are so rude here. Okay, we need to go to the Temple of Mara so we can get this marriage amulet. Alright, so we can actually buy this amulet and skip a quest, but I'm gonna do the quest and get the amulet for free. That's what I prefer to do. So I don't know where this person is. I meant to get the quest from. There you go.
Lady Mara bids you welcome to her benevolence.
Oh, I didn't know she was. Okay.
We are devoted to the goddess Mara, who gave mortals the gift of love, that they might have a hint of eternity. Her blessings are many. To love is to know the true nature of the gods.
Okay. I'd like to receive this
Not
blessing.
All can hear the broad echoes of deepest dawn. To receive the touch of Mara, you must first act as her hands in the world. Explore the facets of the infinite jewel.
All right,
Are you
then.
Prepared, then, to help bring the light across this land?
I guess so. So vague, I don't...
Upon you,
what
child.
Am I doing?
You must bear its light that all may see. Mara has reflected an image to me. At the foot of the throat and the young woman, almost a girl. Her fickle love must resolve itself. The village of Iverstead. The woman? Fastred. This is the prayer heard by the goddess and relayed to her servants. Return when she has seen her path. I will entreat Mara on your behalf.
Alright, so we've got to go help this woman with her love affair, something's going on. We're gonna see if we can help her out and get the blessing of Mara and the amulet, more importantly. Alright, so we're here in Iverstead. We are going to look for this Bastrid lady. Wherever she is. And see what her love problem is.
She's our only child, Bolton. Am I to throw her to the wolves?
You're hardly throwing her to the walls. She just wants to see the world, just like I did when I was her age.
And if she decides to leave Iverstead, what then? No.
Disrespect
no,
the
I can't
law
bear
and
the
disrespect
thought.
Me.
Okay.
If I were you...
So that's a little something from her parents, it seems. Hey.
Are you the one sent by Mara?
Yes. What? Yes, I guess so. How did she even know that?
I think I love him, but he wants to move to Riften afterwards, and my father won't allow it. He only cares about this stupid town. But Bassianus makes me happier than anyone ever has. My mother's not any help either.
I guess I'll try to talk to her parents. So much. It's wonderful to have see what they say.
You ever settled down to have children?
Hey.
You must be another pilgrim.
Oh my gosh, she's so old looking.
No other reason to pass through here.
I don't. No, that's not why.
Oh my. Probably something about the men. We all
wish about the men.
I don't tell my husband. I don't have any problem with Bassianus. Even if it means her leaving Iverstead, I want Fastred to be happy. If they just snuck out of town together, I could manage my husband.
Okay.
Bassianus is still so terrified of Yolkthor. If he knew that I'd keep him from hunting the poor boy down, he'd take Fastred to Riften without a second thought. Let him know that I'll watch out for them. I just want my daughter to be happy.
So, the mom just says for the daughter to run away in the night. That's her idea.
So forgive me if I'm a bit on edge.
Oh, she would like me to speak to you. What the heck? No, I didn't click that. I know, I already went up there.
You a pilgrim or just passing through? I'm sure I know what this is about. She thinks she's in love with Bassianus and wants to leave town. With you. Let me tell you how I see it. Until a few months ago, the girl was head over heels for Clement. Wouldn't stop talking about him. Now, if I thought she was really in love with Bassianus, that would be one thing. But she's a child. It will pass. Look around here. There's not much left. It used to be a good-sized town. The folks have been moving to Riften for a while now. If all the young people leave, what happens to Iverstead?
Nothing.
You know how children are. Her fancies change with the moment. And like always, the boy lacks any kind of spine. He needs some convincing. A little push and this would all be simpler. Just get out of town as fast as you can. Nothing for anyone here.
Alright, so it looks like we have a few options here. We can either talk to this Bassianus guy or Clemic. So, I have a choice. I'm gonna let them. I'm gonna go with the daughter.
Keep an eye out for wolves if you're headed up the path to High Hrothgar.
You've been a good friend like to me. A pilgrim. That means something.
Why bother visiting?
I wish I could make my deliveries more often, but the road's getting dangerous.
She was in love with this guy? He's so old.
7,000 steps indeed. Next time they need to build it closer to the ground.
No, I'll tell you, Wilhelm.
Oh.
What do you want?
Oh my gosh. You should follow your heart.
Oh, my love. How I long to take her away from all of this. Why did Boti send you to me?
Well, she wants you guys to run away together.
More than that brute Yofthor, at least. Yofthor, what about him? He'll come after us and it will be unpleasant.
I think you play
she would.
White's got it under control.
Everything would be all right. I'll go speak to Fastred. Post haste.
Yeah, I definitely don't want that girl to be with this old fart. Gosh. Looks like twice her age.
Never settled down to have children.
Bassianus, sweetie, what is it?
We must leave. Your father will not approve of us, and I grow weary of this place.
Where will we go?
To Riften, my pet. How you'll adore the city.
Oh, and to be with you.
I'll make the preparations immediately.
I guess they don't mind that I'm just there on their personal, private talk. Okay. All right, so I guess we'll go back to Riften and speak with the priestess there, or whatever she is. I think she's a priestess.
Lady Mara bids you welcome to her benevolence. How wonderful. Like the sea, their love roils and swells, but brings life and nourishment to all.
Okay, it's a little dramatic.
I see you are eager to carry the light. As you venture, Mara fills my mind ever more with visions of love in peril. Embers lie nestled in stone, needing only fuel to bloom a flame that will warm all around them. Go to Markarth. There you'll find Kalsomo, wise, acid, and reclusive. Help him to emerge and state his intentions. This is the prayer heard by the goddess and relayed to her servants.
All right, so now we're gonna go help someone else. That lady, I don't... She talks in riddles. That's so obnoxious. So we're gonna have to go to Markarth, which means we have to go to the stables, and probably we'll just take the carriage and fast travel there, because that would be the easiest. I'd probably run there if I weren't on the Let's Play, but this will be much easier.
Need a ride? I can take you to any of the hold camp.
Yes.
Where do you want to go?
We are going to go to Markarth.
Climb and back, and we'll be off.
Okay. Get in this carriage here.
Some say it was built by the dwarves. I don't believe a word of it, though.
He doesn't believe it's built by dwarves. Well, that's good to know. Okay.
This is Markarth, traveler. Safest city in the Reach.
No. No, it's not the safest city at all. Oh boy. Something's going on here. What is this woman? She's just got murdered. I shot him in the neck.
Everyone stay back. The
I'm gonna steal all his stuff.
Guard, have this all under control. There are no forsworn here.
The guards. I'm pretty sure those are my arrows through his body.
Right in front of me.
I saw.
A woman attacked right on the streets. Are you all right? Did you see what happened?
Think about the Forsworn.
Strange. Well, I hope the Eight give you more peace in the future, for what it's worth. Oh, I think you dropped this. Some kind of note. Looks important.
I didn't drop anything.
My note? No, that's yours. Must have fallen out of your pocket.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, then. Well, I guess we'll read the note and see what it says. It'll give us a quest, and we'll do that later. Whoops. Let's see. Meet me at the Shrine of Talos. Okay?
What are you hiding?
I'm not hiding anything. It's closed for a reason.
Typical Imperial lies. First you take away Talos. Now you're keeping us from seeing our honor dead? You and the Jarl will answer for any desecration of my ancestors' bodies.
That's enough, Thongvor. We're done.
What kind of argument here?
If it's about the Hall of the Dead, no. You can't go in there.
Wow. Rude.
I can't talk about it. Rest assured, the Jarl hears everyone's concerns. You will be able to visit the dead again soon.
I guess we'll try to get our speech up.
All right. I was going to suggest the Jarl sort this mess out.
We discovered that some of the dead have been eaten. Flesh has been chewed off. Bones were snapped to get at the marrow inside. We haven't caught anyone or anything yet. It's like it knows when I'm there. If you can get to the bottom of this, the priesthood of Arkay will reward you. Take my key and be careful.
Well, that sounds pretty interesting. Maybe we'll do that next episode.
We don't know what's in there.
For now, we are gonna find this guy. See what his love problem is.
What are you doing here? The excavation site is closed. I don't need any more workers or guards.
Okay, that's nice.
I told you I'm not hiring any more guards. Why do you people always bother me when I'm trying to finish my research? You idiot! Do you even know who I am?
He just called me an idiot for no reason. Oh my gosh.
Bothering me.
No wonder he can't get his love to work out. He's an asshole.
Very stressful work, and I shouldn't have yelled. How can I help you?
You just yelled at me, delivered by Mara.
I'm beginning to lose faith that any help would come.
You just yelled at your god,
you see,
basically.
I've been thinking about Feline quite a bit. You know Feline?
Nope. Why the heck would I know her? Oh, apparently I do. I didn't mean to click that. My chat thing is acting really weird.
And I start to shake. I could never hope to approach her. That's the trouble. I know Feline from the keep. I have no idea what sorts of things she
like I just pushed him out of the way.
It's a simple matter. I could offend her fairly easily by bringing up the wrong subject. I've seen it happen before.
Okay.
There is one. Ingvar. He's quite popular with the ladies. Thankfully, Feline is not quite his type. But they've been friends for some time, and he may have some ideas. Please. Mm-hmm. Ask him what she likes. It's my only chance.
I'm Kalselmo's nephew.
Okay, I don't... Okay, I'm basically spying for this guy to see what his lover likes. That he's apparently never spoken to her before, so he would have no idea. All these relationships in Skyrim are built on such trust and honesty. There he is.
About this house? No. Anyone seen entering or leaving? Any strange lights or unusual noises?
It's abandoned, and it's always been abandoned.
Excuse me, but do you know anything
about
this
house? That guy.
Has anyone enter or leave?
No.
Seems no one in this city has.
Okay, I just need to talk to this guy. I don't want to talk about that house right now. What?
Markarth, is it bloody enough for you?
I guess so.
Then turn around and go back where you came. City doesn't need you, doesn't want you.
Oh.
Blood and silver are what flows through Markarth. That's the way it is. That's the way it'll stay.
That doesn't seem very healthy. Okay, I need to talk about Feline.
Why? Are you interested? Ah, a secret admirer, eh? Don't worry, I won't tell a soul.
Yeah, we'll keep that other guy's role a secret.
I didn't tell you this. Feline likes to act tough, but she really has a soft spot for, of all things, poetry. You know, I took some classes at the Bard's College as a youth. Poems come in handy when wooing. There's a poem I once used on an older lady of Rorikstead. I can change it to be about Feline, if you've got some gold. Are you prepared to receive my golden words?
Oh, that did not sound good. Okay. Let's see if we can negotiate the price.
You got the gold, then.
Oh, no. Alright.
Are you prepared to receive my golden words?
Why does he say it so creepily? Okay, yeah, I guess.
Wonderful.
I guess
write it
so.
Out so you won't forget it. You should probably just let Feline read it herself. Don't want you stumbling over the words and ruining my flow.
Okay. There she is.
You! Who are you to approach the Jarl of Markarth? Very well. You may approach the mournful throne, but watch your words. Kalselmo, what about him? Fangubum? He's an odd little man, always poking around the rooms and wasting time in his museum. Seems friendly enough, obviously intelligent. Why do you ask?
I don't know if we're supposed to say this or not.
You're out of your mind. That old poot's more interested in dead dwarves than anybody around here. Don't talk such rot. Please, stop wasting my time. You're embarrassing yourself.
Okay, I guess...
As his... Pardon me?
We're just supposed to read this poem.
I'm not sure what this is all about.
I just told you he has feelings for you, and you didn't believe me.
Kalselmo wrote this? About me? I never knew he had such feeling in him. Clearly, I've never even thought of him in that manner. I wish that I was as skilled with words as he. Here, take in this letter. I may not be as eloquent as he is, but I hope he understands.
The Dominion is here.
I'm Kalselmo's nephew.
I have things to study. What is it?
A letter from Feline.
This is more than I could have hoped for. Have you really done this for me? I have to see her. Please excuse me.
Okay.
Yes, yes, I have a lot of research to do.
He's running. He's running to see her. Oh my gosh, this is so funny. Literally running. The NPCs never run. Oh my gosh.
Feline, I...
Shh. It's all right. You don't need to say anymore. I had no idea you were so nuanced.
I love you.
So I hear. Come here, you.
Good to see Skyrim
what?
Still has such fine people. You give an old man hope.
Okay, that was the weirdest encounter ever. Those people have apparently never spoken before, and they love each other. No big deal. All right. So now we'll go back to the Temple of Mara and see if that's the last thing we have to do or what. Might have to help someone else too. We'll see.
Lady Mara bids you welcome to her benevolence. The goddess smiles at your efforts, child. The dawn shines bright upon you.
Okay.
You have seen the young, fickle love of youth and helped a more seasoned love find its way. There is one final aspect we wish for you to explore. For a strong love can withstand storms and even survive death.
Oh boy.
Take this symbol of Mara. She will guide you to the wandering souls of two whose love was so great that their entwinement binds them to this world. May you carry the warmth of Mara to all corners of the frozen wastes.
So we got the amulet. That's what we've been kind of waiting for this whole time. But we're going to finish out the quests because I don't want to have a quest that it's unfinished. Here? Oh, here. In the middle of nowhere. I guess we'll run from the watchtower. It's probably the easiest way.
What's a milk drinker like you doing out here? Go home to your mother.
A milk drinker? What the heck? I don't know what that means, but what? Don't talk to what me like do? That.
Cry? I don't have to take that from you.
Oh man, we're gonna get in a fight.
Come here. Give up while you still can.
Alright, we're gonna level up quick. Let's see. I think we'll get stamina to 150 and then we'll do more health. And perks. Let's see. I don't have enough skill for that. I guess we'll do lockpicking. That's a pretty useful skill. Healing. Oh, that was a terrible miss. Oh. That's kind of weird, the animation. Anyway. So we beat this random orc who tried to pick a fight with us. Why does everyone try to fight the Dragonborn? Do they know? They know who I am? Yeah, the ghosts are just up here, so we're gonna see what, if we can help them or what we're gonna do about it. I'm not really sure. Hello. Rookie.
I'm searching for my Fenric. He was marching with you, Cosmen, who they say were wiped out here. I've turned over everybody, though, and I can't find him. Please help me look. He has a bright red beard and hair.
Let's see any bodies here.
Either help me or be gone. Are you a fool? Look at the bodies around you. Even if you're blind, surely you can smell the blood. Come, help me search for Fenric. He must be here somewhere.
Okay. Oh, here he is.
We're expected to fight there tomorrow. Joker elected to camp here for the night. I don't like it, though.
Why doesn't he
our
like camping there?
Our fires are visible for miles. We're in a low valley. Sitting ducks. If she's come this far from home, it must be important. Lead on. I just need to report back to camp by sunrise.
So neither of the ghosts realize that time has passed and they're dead. That's sad. You following? Oh no. I guess not. Alright, so we can finally reunite these lovers.
Fenrir, you're alive.
Of course.
No.
What brings you here?
I had heard that Gyukar's men were wiped out. I came to find you.
But that battle isn't expected until tomorrow. Rookie, what's going on?
Oh.
I'm so confused. What's happening?
It doesn't matter. I'm here. We're together now. And we will be forever.
Okay. Whoa! They started following again. Okay, we're gonna go back to the temple. I believe that was the final step, so now we can unlock marriage. Well, technically we already can because we have the amulet. But now I can finish the quest and actually do something.
The Dawnguard is looking for anyone willing to fight against the growing vampire menace. What do you say?
Not right now, I'm busy.
Alright then.
I'm busy trying to find a spouse. And adopt children.
Need something?
Lady Mara bids you welcome to her benevolent.
All right, I've helped everyone.
The entire province. I trust by now you've achieved a higher comprehension of love.
Oh,
carry
yes, indeed.
Carry the blessings of Mara with you, so the rest of the province may shine with her glories.
All right.
Good journey, my child.
So now we can get married. Alright, so I thought a really long time about who we should marry in the game, and I finally settled on a woman from Whiterun. She's right up here. Her name is Yosalda. So all we need to do is give her a mammoth tusk, which I got. I just bought it at the trader because giants are a little too tough for us right now, and we have to give her this tusk. So, should be somewhere around here. Right? Looks like she is right over here in her little house. So, I wonder if we can break in. Get mad at us if we break in. We're about to be her wife or whatever, so. But I have this photo.
I'm not going to warn you.
Dang.
You're not supposed to be in here.
I'm trying to leave. Even my follower is yelling at me. Okay, now she's outside.
Once I've made enough money trading with the Khajiit caravans, I'm going to buy the bannered mare from Hulda.
Okay.
Thank you. This should turn that old cat's gaze. Maybe I'll be able to become a caravaneer myself one day. As promised. Let me show you a thing or two about bargaining. Don't want some shifty merchant giving you a raw trade.
Alright, so she increased our speech. Alright, we had to make a quick little stop and speak to the priest to fully unlock the marriage. We didn't have to buy the amulet from him, but...
I'm surprised someone like you isn't spoken for.
Hmm.
Well, yes, why wouldn't I be? Are you interested in me?
Yes.
It's settled then. Brief as life can be in Skyrim, at least we'll have each other.
All right then.
It's delicious.
Do you get to the
so, I just gave her a mammoth tusk earlier, and now she likes me so much, we're gonna get married. So let's go arrange our wedding.
How may I help you, my daughter?
I'd like to have a wedding.
You wish to be married?
Yes.
It's good to see love blossoming even during these difficult times.
Mm-hmm.
Your wedding will be held tomorrow, from dawn until dusk.
Oh boy.
Don't be late. You don't want to miss your own wedding. May you return to her benevolence in safety.
All right, so it's time for our wedding. Safety.
Ah, here's the blushing bride now. Let's begin the ceremony. It was Mara that first gave birth to all of creation and pledged to watch over us as her children. It is from her love of us that we first learn to love one another. It is from this love that we learn that a life lived alone is no life at all.
Better live with a stranger who I've only talked to once.
To bear witness to the union of two souls in eternal companionship. May they journey forth together in this life. And in the next, in prosperity and
poverty,
oh,
it makes such a weird couple.
And hardship. Do you agree to be bound together in love, now and forever?
I couldn't even be bothered to take my armor off.
Now and forever.
Do you agree to be bound together in love, now and forever? Under the authority of Mara, the divine of love, I declare this couple to be wed.
Yay.
I present the two of you with these matching rings, blessed by Mara's divine grace. May they protect each of you in your new life together.
We're married. I guess we'll need to decide where we're living, won't we? You can always stay with me.
Wait, come back.
Congratulations on your wedding. I am so happy for
you. I do not want to live with you in your house. I would like you to live in my house.
I'll see you there.
Okay. So we got married. Yay! Let's fast travel and see if she will already be home when we get there. Alright, so we've made it home. And the house is still completely empty, but now we've got a wife. So she'll be able to take care of the children while we're gone. Lydia is also around here somewhere, and she can help take care of the kids, and I can go travel the countryside and save the world over and over again. So yeah, I guess in the next episode we'll adopt some kids, because this episode is getting a little long now. So yeah, we'll find some kids to adopt. We'll probably find them in the cities of Skyrim. There's a bunch of little homeless children that just run around and beg for money and live with any stranger who asks them to. So we'll choose one of those kids or two, and we'll get our happy little family here, and then we'll go off and do some fun quests. Hope you enjoyed the episode. If you did, make sure to give it a like and subscribe to my channel, because I post Skyrim videos every Tuesday and Thursdays. Thanks for watching. Hope to see you in the next video. Until then, bye!